I just really want to know what Lil Uzi Vert meant when he said human centipede and why he said it.
I mean, it might be one of those, like, let's analyze it and distill it down to what it really means.
We have a new song that just was literally just released by Bring Me the Horizon. It's called Amen! Exclamation point. Featuring Lil Uzi Vert and Daryl Palumble of Glassjaw.
Okay.
I saw one of our friends in Pulse's tweet about this and said, if the song isn't good, we will not stop hearing about it. And I am firmly agreed on that point.
Okay. I actually haven't heard this song yet. So
it's about an hour old. So let's take our first listen and our initial thoughts to the new Bring Me the Horizon song.
I hope you have fun.
Good.
I was about to say, this is like their older stuff.
Yes. Also insane that they have been putting out all this pop shit and then like, never mind.
Yeah, they're like, oh, hey, I got you. In. Now listen to this.
A little bit of post-hardcore angry shit. All right, let's go. All right, that's sick. Having Daryl Palumbo on a song is sick as fuck. I
like that transition.
That was sick as fuck.
Give me more.
All right, Daryl. Thank you, Daryl. Give me more. Your fanatics pray on me, hate on me, patiently waiting to watch me bleed. Get your hair from out of my ass. Got me feeling like a human centipede. Let me breathe. I'm sorry. I'm just going to scroll down. There are no lyrics yet. But
I heard
I'm
human
sure,
centipede.
I'm pretty sure he just said human centipede. So
for that, Uzi, this smacks.
All right, Uzi. It's interesting because there's a very like post-hardcore style and vibe to it. And then the chorus is just like straight up like current metal, like Falling in Reverse Architects shit.
I feel like they're trying to mix everything to make everybody happy. But here's the thing. They're actually doing it pretty well.
It's definitely good. And obviously we're only about halfway through it. But putting in a Glassjaw section and a Lil Uzi Vert section
back
are like so cool and unique in this sort of like modern emo metal scene that it's like, hey, do we have to go back to the emo metal scene? Like, just keep us in that new realm.
It's like we already really cool. had us hooked. I'm wondering if they would just be like, hey, maybe make sure it's still playable for like radio. No. That would be my thing.
But like,
that's like the kind of trend right now we see.
Yeah. I don't like it. I'm just going to say it, you know. Fuck radio. All right, this is cool.
Yeah.
The breakdown's cool. That's a pretty good breakdown.
Yeah.
I like that it's longer than just like a short little like bridge.
They fuse it
part.
To fill the time.
Yeah. There's like a little bit of like older Bring Me the Horizon in there from like their more heavy records before Sempiternal. Of like the like choppiness and weird little bits that happen in there. That was when it was produced by Skrillex. That is correct. And having Lil Uzi Vert on some of this breakdown is also, I think, giving it a little bit of, yeah, a little bit of different flavor. Okay, you're gonna hate how I describe this, but that section there was a very like Falling in Reverse ass shit.
Don't say that.
Because like,
don't say that.
Falling in Reverse does a lot of that, like, you know what? Fuck it. We're going to do double time here, double time kicks and shit. And just like for this one little section. And there's like this big booming chorus with long held out notes and shit. And then there's like, yeah, double time kick. Yeah. And it's like just that sort of like ADD type vibe in the chorus. Obviously, I don't ever want to compare anybody to Falling in Reverse because Falling in Reverse is basically just Ronnie Radke doing whatever. But at the same time, like they have had a pretty big influence on these genres and they're gigantic in this scene of music. So like they kind of have to be compared to in some of this. And no, I'm not happy about it, but they did it and it's still cool. There. I'm glad that it's on a Bring Me song instead of a Falling in Reverse song. Okay. So for sure, the best part of that song is Daryl Palumbo. Like straight up just an absolute fact that the best part of that song is Daryl Palumbo. But I do think with a lot of people being annoyed on the internet because all the last few like Bring Me songs they released were quite poppy, quite more of like not a heavy sound, not even in the way like what we got for the first Posthuman, having more of that, like they released like some heaviness in that, but then they released the EP and it was a lot more heavy. And so I'm hoping that ends up being the same kind of thing here with this one. I like that they are putting out something heavy, and I like that it has a good breakdown, and it has Daryl Palumbo being just a phenomenal singer on it.
Yeah, I think also with something to say, because this dropped like an hour ago, first day of Pride Month, and they literally have like, hey, Assembly of God, here's some rainbows, and then here's some hard music.
Yeah, I think they understood that, you know, this is going to be a month of sin, and so they needed to do something to kind of bring all of the people back from the edge.
Yeah, just say amen and just go to church.
Yeah, you know what, this Pride Month, go to church.
But like, you know, like the Hosier take me to church type of vibe, you know.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, well anyway, good job Bring Me, we like this one.
Yeah.
Keep up the heavy and the poppy, and bringing in people like Daryl Palumbo and Lil Uzi Vert to be on your song.